In this video, I talk about how to mix light grey paint. I've been working on this painting and I've obviously got to the point where I need to paint the dolphin. And for that, I need to mix light grey paint. So let's go for the first mix. And I think what I need is going to be a little bit of opera rose. Really? Hello, pink. So opera rose. But make sure you got more than you think you'll need. How much is that then? Difficult to say really, isn't it? So make sure you got quite a reasonable amount of it. Because it's going to be a triple mix, you don't have to try and mix the same colour again. And we will be changing this colour by adding a bit more brown in there, a bit more blue in there, you know, as we go along as well. So just remember that once you've got this colour on, you know, you can make more than one version of this. So you can steal some of that from that one and put it in the next well, whatever you want to do. I'm just going to make just this one version initially of this one. And we'll go for a little bit of burnt umber. Again, don't do this over the top of your painting, okay? And that'll change that colour straight away, as you can see there, of a browny pink. And then I'm going to go for a little bit of French ultramarine or ultramarine blue or whatever ultramarine that you have within your painting kit. And you can see that's changed it a little bit, but not enough. It's still too pink. So let's get some more. And you want this mix more to a milky consistency again. I go milky quite a lot, don't I? I really do. And that's more like a bluey purple, isn't it, on there at the moment? So you can change this and mix it around to whatever colour you want. And remember to offer that colour on your test pieces of paper like I do to the reference photograph. And you think, it's too purple. So then if it's too purple, you want to change that flavour a little bit more. And then add a bit more brown, for example. And if it's too brown, you change it back. Add a bit more blue, add a bit more pink. Until you get that right colour. Take your time and you'll get there eventually. But this is why you want to make more than you think you'll need, because you don't have to go through this process again trying to get that, well, that right colour. I mean, what's that one like there? Let's just try that one a minute. Put my paints down a minute. Let's get another clear piece of paper here. And you can see that's now more of a grey colour. That's looking better, isn't it? So that's what I'm looking at, something like that. So I'm going to go for a little bit more blue just to change it slightly. Okay. That's much more like it. There you go. So let's just wet the thin. So do that first of all. And because we've got sort of nearly a line going down the bottom there, we've got something to work to. So let's get the same colour again and we'll drop this one in. Now you can see there's a little bit too blue, but that's easy enough to fix. I'll show you what I mean. Bring that down to that line there. We can get a little bit of burnt umber straight from the half pan, just a small amount like that, hardly touching it. We'll drop that in just to brown it slightly. There's a bit of brown in there, isn't there? So I'm going to tap in a little bit more burnt umber in there, just a small amount. And then you know that every layer of paint you add will get darker and darker and darker. And that's the way it will work with any colour that you add on there.
The good thing when you're working on a painting like this is that you can add colour into the same mixing well with my mixing palette. So I'm going to grab a little bit of colour, a little bit of opera rose, and mix that with this kind of bluey grey I've got. And this will warm it up a little bit. And I can add this into just parts of the thin, just to vary that colour, just a fraction as well. Because you have to think about all the colours that you can see within that reference photograph, in this case obviously the dolphin. So when you really pinch in and look very, very closely, you can actually see more than what you initially thought. I mean, oh, a little bit of pink in there. So what I'm doing, I'm adding a very light grey mix first of all onto this dolphin's body. Once that is nice and bone dry, then I can add another layer over the top. And every layer that I add will add deeper tone, better colour. So it could really enrich the colour. But also we can fine tune those washes as well to create more shape at the same time. So some of the areas will be lighter, some obviously darker, and to give you more of a rounded feel to the dolphin. And this in turn gives us that base as well for when we start adding the details over the top. You probably notice as well, when I start adding this grey on there, I'm going to try and maintain a wet edge. Now, because I've got a board which is on a slight angle, that allows the wetness of this edge to be at the lower part of this line. So in other words, because it's still wet down there, I can keep maintaining the wetness of the paper or the wetness of the paint without it drying and leaving lines as well, like very streaky lines. But you also notice as well that I'm using the same colour, the same wash. I've not added more paint to it, I've not added more water to it within my mixing palette here. Because every layer that we add, that colour will get richer. The tone will be really bright. And also, it'll get much darker as well. That's another good way of controlling the paint and controlling the overall tonal values of a picture without having to change the actual mix itself. Just remember though, allow each layer to dry first, okay? When you use a damp, clean brush on the wet edge of this paint line, then you can soften it down. So you can really lighten it as it comes away from that one edge. And this in turn gives you a very soft, diffused looking wash as well on the painting, which is why I like to work this way. So you're not going to affect the entire area of paint, just that bottom lower edge. And that will soften the edge of that line. So you can do that right to the white of the paper if you wanted to. Or in this case, the kind of grey-blue background I've already got on there. So that is how to mix light grey paint and use it and change it within a painting. For more videos on paint mixing, check out the video to the top right. I'll see you there.